Stress at a point. Usually, when we are asked to explain stress, we say that it is forced by area and all. But actually, if we are having a material and if a force is acting on this material, suppose say this is the material and here a force is acting, and if you are asked to find the stress at this particular point, then the peculiarity is that we can draw infinite number of planes through this point. And as plane changes, the area changes. And because of this changing area, force by area will have different values. So, through a point, there is the possibility of infinite number of planes. And because of this infinite number of planes, there will be infinite stress vectors. That means, for a point, we cannot say a particular stress value. The totality of all these stress vectors acting on every possible of these planes can be explained as the stress acting at this point. Now, the problem is, so while we are considering different planes, we will have different stresses. That means by changing the direction of normal of these planes, we will have different stresses, and it will be very difficult to obtain the stress at various points. And here, if we have a point and if we know the stresses at three mutually perpendicular planes, here let us say ZY is on plane, XZ is another plane, XY is another plane. So these three planes are perpendicular. And then let's first take this plane, XZ plane. In XZ planes, there is a direct stress sigma y, then there is tau XZ a shear stress, and tau YZ another shear stress. And we have shown that here, tau XY, sigma y, tau YZ. Similarly, in all these three planes, there will be different stresses. In the X plane means this plane, YZ plane. We are calling this YZ plane as X plane because the normal of YZ plane is X axis. So in XY plane, there is sigma X, tau XY, tau XZ. In Y plane, there is sigma Y, tau XY, tau YZ. And in Z plane, there is sigma Z, tau XZ, tau YZ. So if we have the component of stresses in three mutually perpendicular planes, then we can write them in a matrix form as shown here. So after writing it, so now what we have is, we have the stress in X plane, that is sigma X, tau XY, tau XZ, in Y plane and in Z plane. So for three mutually perpendicular planes, we have stress. And if we are asked to find the stress at a point, stress at a plane which have a normal Nx, Ny, Nz, then it is simple. Multiply this matrix with the Nx, Ny, Nz, we will get the stress at that particular plane. So if we have another plane whose normal is Nx1, Ny1, Nz1, and if we are asked to find the stress at this particular plane, then what we have to do is, we have to multiply the given stress matrix with Ny1, Nz1, Nx1, Ny1, Nz1. So if we know the stress, at three mutually perpendicular planes, we can easily find the stress at a plane whose normal is given. So here, this formula is called Cauchy's formula, and by this we can come to a conclusion that by changing the planes of our consideration, the stress will take different values, and the totality of all the stress can be called as stress at a point. Thank you.